Please give us a brief introduction.
Sir, I am from Mahanagar in the district of Cuttack. I have passed out my class 10 board examination from Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya. Then I have passed out my class 12th exam from Pevensa Junior College. Then I pursued my graduation in electrical engineering from CET Bhubaneswar. Then I served TCS as a system engineer for 2 years. Then I was selected in as a supervisor in ICDS project in the block of Mahanagar. Then I served as an ASO. Now I am serving as an ASO in the Lok Seva Bhavan, Bhubaneswar.
Okay. Which department you are serving?
So Department of Women and Child Development and Mission Shakti.
Women and Child Development, Mission Shakti. There you are serving. So you are basically from Cuttack, right?
Yes.
Cuttack district.
Yes.
Okay. So something recently your department was in the news, why?
Sir, for 2 reasons. One is Mission Shakti Mela was going on from December 6 to December 15, which was a great platform for all the rural Mission Shakti Swayam Sahayaka Goshthi to show their productivity, and about 6 crore business was conducted at that Mela. And another thing is that it was there was a deal with Flipkart of Mission Shakti Directorate that the products of Mission Shakti, that is Swayam Sahayaka, these will be sold in the Flipkart background so as to make it more popular. Another is about water connection, that is all the water bill that will be collected by the Swayam Sahayaka Goshthis in the Bhubaneswar, and it will gradually implemented to all the districts.
Okay, what is that called, that project?
Sir, it is called Jala Jivan.
Jala Sakhi.
Jala Sakhi, sir.
And particularly your department was in news before 2-3 days. The 5G was implemented in your department?
Yes, sir. It has already implemented since about a month.
Okay, but it came in the newspaper?
Sir, it is about to implement in a particular scheme that is called Mamata scheme, which is for the benefits of the pregnant women of our society. It is giving them incentive, that is direct cash transfer in 2 installments, that is 3000 and 2000.
So working with the Women and Child Development Department, right, and Mission Shakti.
Yes, sir.
So can you tell me 3 successes of Mission Shakti and 3 reforms that are still needed in Mission Shakti?
Sir, first success is that it is able to make the women who were previously called so-called in Odia, Chopada and Durbada, this scheme able to empower them to make them financially able, and they are now gaining the decision-making capacity in their house, and they are producing things which are of very valuable things, which is giving them economic benefits. And it is also like Hastatantra and all the handicraft work they are dealing with, and the productive work like fisheries. And another benefit is that this Mission Shakti also involved in our ICDS project as Chatua, producing Chatua. That is take to home ration service, and all the Chatua plant, all it is maintained by the Mission Shakti. And now government has decided to include Mission Shakti productive work or not.
Okay. So, what is the most important international news that you know in the last 2-3 days?
Sir, about the impeachment of the President of America, that is Donald Trump, Mr. Donald Trump.
In which house he has been impeached?
Sir, in the lower house.
The lower house, what is that called?
Sir, it is called House of Republican House.
Republic Party, that it's a
party of party. Yes.
That is the Republican Party. Yes. But what is the house?
I'm sorry, sir.
So what are the two houses they are having there?
Sir, one house is Senate.
Mm-hmm. Then?
Another is, can I guess?
If you know, you say.
Sir, is it democratic?
There are two houses. One is the lower house of what you call for the election elect people are there. That is the House of Representatives.
Representatives.
Okay. That has given for impeachment. Next is like we have a House of the states. Similarly, they have a Senate, 100 member Senate. There are 50 states. Each state will send 2 people. Okay. So, what is the process of impeachment? Now, one house is impeached, then what happens next?
So, then it will go to the Senate.
Mm-hmm.
And about 2/3 members have to vote in favor of it for the impeachment.
Mm-hmm. Then, is it the first president?
No, sir. Before there were two presidents. That is, one is Bill Clinton.
Mm-hmm.
Nixon, yes.
Nixon resigned before.
He was not impeached. He resigned before that came to the Senate.
Then who was the first one?
Sir, actually, Bill Clinton. He was also not impeached.
Bill Clinton was the second person.
Second person, and Nixon was the first person against whom impeachment was. Proposed.
Just check it, okay? Whether Nixon was the first person, someone else was the first person, okay?
Okay, sir.
He is the third person to be impeached by the House of Representatives, okay? Earlier, House of Representatives impeached 2 people, right? And in case of Nixon, before the House went to the vote, he resigned from the presidency. So, he could not be impeached. Understood?
Yes.
Okay. So, other world news going on?
Sir, other world news is about the discussion of vodka and its effect in different countries like USA is discussing it, and our neighboring countries like Pakistan, Bangladesh, it is also discussing about that. And another news is also there about the ex-president, ex-prime minister of Pakistan, that is Musharraf.
Was prime minister or president?
Sir, he was the president, sir, I think the president of Pakistan, Musharraf, that is a verdict was listed that he will be hanged.
Okay.
Hanging verdict was this.
Okay. What about China's attempt to bring India's action in Kashmir to the United Nations Security Council? What happened? China proposed to have a discussion on it, but it would not happen. Which country vetoed it?
Sorry, sir.
France, okay. Yes. France did not allow it. France vetoed it, so it could not.
Yes.
Okay. So, hobby is cooking.
Yes, sir.
Cooking what? Which type of dishes you would like to cook?
Sir, I like to cook dishes like North Indian dishes, like our Odisha's main dish like dalma. I like to cook. Then I like to cook chicken curry, chicken and mutton curries. also I like to cook poha.
No, what we can say authentic Odia cuisine? Can you any dish that you have prepared authentic Odia cuisine?
Sir, dalma.
Dalma. Dalma, can you tell me something because you have home science as the one of your optionals. So you can tell me something about the nutritive value of dalma and you know what all nutrients and what all things are there in dalma. Generally you can tell me about that.
Sir, dalma mainly consists of pulses which has protein inside it. So protein has nutrient value. Then we can add several other vegetables like potato, tomato. Potato having carbohydrates, so from it we can get carbohydrate. And tomato, then it has antioxidant capacity, vitamin E. And beans, beans has protein as value in it. Then we can add also that is so called desi aloo in dalma. And we can add also like cauliflower we can add. So it depends how much vegetables we have and the nutrient value will gradually increase. And we can add also gajar, that is gajar and all other so in and I can say that we can add different types of pulses in it. Like if we are not monotonous, then we can add tur dal and moong dal, we can combine it, so the nutrient value can increase. So it is very healthy.
Okay. So in home science, you have studied about home science extension and community development, and you are also working in you know that area. So can you tell me how evaluation of a project is done? Evaluation was you have started a project, okay? A project you have implemented it. Now how can you say that that project is successful or unsuccessful, whatever? How that project is going to be evaluated? Can you tell me the methods of evaluation or the steps in the evaluation process?
Sir, first thing is step-wise evaluation. We have to, when the project is going on, in between we have to calculate what is the output of this project. We have to go to the field and see is it functioning in the manner we intended or not. If that is functioning, then we have to continue in that path, or if it is in the meantime, if it is not functioning, then we can direct in another path so that it can be implemented well.
Okay, you have written that you have participated in state national level Olympiad.
Yes, sir.
Mathematics Olympiad?
Yes, sir.
So you represented Odisha?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And what happened basically? Like, what was. You participated there?
Yes, sir. Actually, sir, it is an exam. It is an exam in which we have to give the written exam. Then I gave the written exam, then I got qualified.
You were qualified?
Yes, sir.
So can you tell me some famous mathematicians, someone who is called human computer in India, who was he or she? He or she could do thousands and thousands of calculations in seconds without any help, just through mind.
Sir, yes,
Sir
Vijay Chandra, can you take just a minute to?
You can just recall it, right? I can give you a hint.
Yes.
He's one of the very famous characters of Kalidas.
Sorry, sir.
Have you heard the name of Shakuntala Devi?
Yes, sir.
Hmm?
Yes, sir.
Okay. She's a human computer interface. Okay. Now coming to mainstream mathematicians, to name three or four famous mathematicians of India whom everyone knows, right from ancient times to the modern times, at least tell me three or four people related to mathematics.
Sir, Aryabhatta.
Varahamihira.
Yes, sir.
What did Varahamihira do? What was his contribution?
Sir, measuring the length of so-called the hills and mountains.
Fine. Then? Most famous? Srinivasa Ramanujan?
Yes,
huh?
I couldn't remember. Okay.
So, the Regional Science Congress you participated. What was your project?
Sir, it is not a project actually. It is a platform in which the persons who secured the highest mark in 9th class, they are selected in different schools of that particular Bhopal region, and they are taken to visit different places related to science. Like we had visited the SIPHA, and that is Regional Institute of Science, all things we had visited in class 10th.
Okay. Optionals are home science and political science in IIT, right?
Yes, sir.
Currently, what is going on between US and China, specifically in the last 10-15 days?
Sir, economic war was going on between China and America, and it finally got settled with different terms and conditions from both the sides. China, the term and condition for America is I want to tell the term and conditions for China. It is to purchase about $200 billion American products within 2 years. And for America, it will not impose any restriction upon different products of China, like laptop and mobile, which it had imposed.
China is a major economic power, okay, and it is having a very large population, even larger than India.
Yes, sir.
What is the reason that you think that China went ahead of India? India has always been a democracy, okay. India has been always, it has been a tolerant nation. Despite all these things, China has become a bigger economic power. Its market is far bigger than India. Why? What has happened? What they could do that we could not do.
Sir, about China, political power, which is a kind of unitary government prevalent there, and that unitary government, I think that is more favorable towards all the economic growth prospectors. Like in our country, the government is changing from 5 years to 5 years. So if any scheme or any kind of implementation is going to be there, then that government needs to come back again. So that is one reason. And another is, so their electronic, field of electronic development is more ahead than us. Like the phones and laptop, their production, more manufacture oriented production is there.
More manufacture oriented productions. So, can you tell me what are the political views of Sri Aurobindo Ghosh?
Yes, sir. Sir, he was the extremist. He belongs to extremist. That is the group of in that period, an extremist group of Congress was there. He belonged to that group, and he believed in Swarajya, using Swarajya and boycott. That is using the products of our own nation, which are manufactured in our own nation, to encourage our own manufacturers and to improve their economy, and to boycott the foreign products.
Okay, so he started a style of education called integral education. Can you know something about it? Can you tell me?
Yes, sir. Sir, it is somewhat a combination of education with spiritual development.
Education with?
Spiritual development.
Spiritual development.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, you have been working as a, in different capacities. First, you were a systems engineer, so you were in a technical job.
Yes.
But then after that, you came to the government sector. And till now you're working there. What is the difference? Tell me three differences and three similarities that you found in your software job and the present government jobs that you're doing. Three similarities, three differences.
Sir, going to the similarities, in both the field I had to work, and I given my best, and that is the time frame and the completion of work within stipulated time. These principles were followed there, and the hard work prospectus. And going to the differences in as a software engineer, it was very static and mechanized. And but as a government officer, I am working in dynamic fields. Like I worked in villages, I had gone to the field for the work. And as an ASO, I am working for the scheme. So the problems of the people are never ending. If a problem gets solved, then another problem arises. That is, it is a never ending process. It is a very dynamic prospect. And another difference is that the condition, working condition, and the infrastructure of software industries, it is like a 5-star hotel with all the luxuries and AC conditioner, AC, and even AC was there in the bathroom also. So it is like a 5-star hotel and luxurious environment. But as a government servant, I had to work in various, I can say, when I was doing field work, I was traveling in sunny weather too. And in summer season, I had to travel to the field work. So in government services, the condition of work doesn't matter. We have to give our best. And in corporate sector, the main aim of any corporate or company is to gain profit. But the main aim of government service is for the social welfare and betterment of the people of our state.
That is one you have said. Then other differences?
Sir, one is the work culture. Second is the infrastructure. And third is, that is the aim.
Okay. Fine. Suppose you are in a situation where few people are demanding something. You are unable to provide them the assurance because what they are demanding, maybe it's impossible for the government to do it. And they are agitating. You slowly you have gone for a general meeting with the people, okay, to their village,
yes,
along with one or two staff. And now they are agitating. They are saying that we will not allow you to leave the place till our demands are met, and you will give it in writing to us. They have also taken away your phone,
yes,
so that you cannot call anyone. What are you going to do in that case?
Sir, first thing, I will convince them.
Mm.
I will convince them in a pleasing behavior. Then I will talk with the leaders of that agitation. There are few leaders which intensify the people. So I will personally discuss with them and convince them about the situation and tell them that I will try my best to approach the higher officials regarding the issues,
mm-hmm,
and I will write down their issues and to make them assure that the thing, the process is starting. So in this manner I will tackle the situation.
But suppose they will say that no, if they are not ready to accept or agree to what you are saying, and they have detained you, and they have detained your other staff also. Okay, then what are you going to do?
Sir,
they have taken your mobile phones also, so that you cannot call anyone.
Sir, again, I
will
in a pleasing voice, I will tell them that. You see, all the problems of yours I have written down, and I will further proceed with the same, and I will inform my higher officers. And if this is not enough for you, and if you will treat us like this, then as a government servant, we are over a government duty. So we can go against you. By after that, you the police will come, and it will, a criminal case will go against you. So. Both of us should be understanding, and you should understand my situation. If you will detain me like this, I cannot. You are not giving me the chance to proceed with your demands. And if you allow us to go, then peacefully we will surely proceed with your demands. But if you are not allowing us to go, then as we are in government duty, then if in after the duty, then our office staff, they will surely they know that we are here, so they will surely come with the police. Then you will be in problem. Then I will make understand their local leaders about the incident that will be happening up if they are detaining us, for forcefully detaining us. And I will also give some examples regarding this, and in a pleasing voice I will pursue them that not to agitate.
No, if they tell you that well, we will allow you to go only in one condition, you give us a writing that our demands will be met, only then we will allow you. What will you do?
Sir, for the situation, if the agitation is severe, then I can write that I will proceed with the decisions and I will forward it to my higher officers. That I will write in the letter.
They are saying that you have to write that our demands will be fulfilled. Suppose there are 5 demands. They are saying that yes, I agree to that, your 5 demands will be fulfilled by the government. They are asking you to write that. And sign.
Sir, in that particular situation, I make them. I assure them that what demands you are arising, that is not within my level. First, I have to discuss with the government, and then I will make you sure what is the resource available. Then what we can provide. But I will try my best. And again, if they are forcing me. Then for the time, for that time, I will write, and again I will come and I will inform all these incidents to the police as well as my higher officers.
Okay. Can't you just write, yes, all your demands will be fulfilled as per the rules and the constitution. As per the law of the land and the constitution. Finish. Your demands will be fulfilled. But as per the law of the land and the constitution. Whatever is in the law, that is going to happen. If they are asking that we will give us some government land, that is not possible. That is not there in the constitution. So you are just saying, yes, all your demands will be fulfilled as per the okay, is law of the land or as per the laws, okay, and the constitutions. That's what you should just tell them. Okay, but you, whatever you said also is correct, because at that time mob psychology is not to understand. They will not understand anything. Have you seen the visuals?
Yes, sir.
Of yesterday and day before yesterday of the agitations going on?
Yes, sir.
About CAA?
CAA, yes,
huh?
Yes, sir.
We, all have, we also have had agitations in Odisha.
Yes,
but there has been no violence in Odisha. Can you tell me why there is this difference? In Odisha also people are protesting, but they are protesting peacefully. They are not burning the public property, they are not destroying the public property. Whereas in other states, West Bengal, you see in Kerala, you see in Delhi, in some parts, in Uttar Pradesh now it has started. So all these places, why there is violence? But in Odisha, same thing is there. Here violence is not there.
Sir, one difference I found that the local leaders to whom the people are following in those places, they are instigating the people that this law is against the Muslim. So it is
in Uttar Pradesh, there is Yogi Adityanath government.
No, sir, in West Bengal, Kerala, and that is in West Bengal and Punjab also, they are the leaders like Mamata Banerjee. They are telling that they are openly against this particular act.
Okay, what is the what our honorable chief minister has said about this, about CAB and NRC?
Sir, he said that it is a CAA is for the foreigner immigrants and it is not for the Muslims who are originally living in our country, who are the citizens of our country.
So they are supporting it or not?
Sir?
Our government, state government, is supporting CAA and NRC or not?
Sir, it is supporting CAA but not supporting NRC.
Not supporting NRC.
Yes,
why?
Sir, NRC is a, it is a register which registers the who are the citizens of India, and it will exclude who are not citizen and illegal immigrant. They will be from out of the country. So as it is throwing people out of the state, that is out of the country, from humanitarian point of view, it is not supporting NRC.
Okay, so that means we should welcome everyone. Please come to Odisha, it's open. We have so many, so much resources, so much jobs. Come and visit it, like European countries are doing.
No, sir.
Then what? What are you saying?
Sir, the people...
You forget what the government is saying. What is your opinion? Should we welcome immigrants, illegal immigrants?
No, sir.
We are not welcoming them. Anyway, they are coming in and they are settling in places like Bhadrak, Chandrapada. They are all illegal immigrants. So, what is the... Have you taken geography as your optional? No. But anyway, in human geography, you have studied about migration. If this migration continues, what is the problem?
Sir, there will be division of resources, division of employment,
yes,
and all the problems.
Demography, social structure will change.
Will change. Yes.
Do we want that? We don't want that.
No, sir.
If you see all the states, West Bengal, Assam, Odisha has been relatively peaceful. We don't have these kind of problems much, but if this continues, then yes, then what time will come when it will happen in Odisha also.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you tell me, are you aware, have you gone through the draft of the Citizens Amendment Act or the actual act, have you gone through the act?
Yes, sir.
What are the provisions?
Sir, there are two provisions, Citizenship Amendment Act. In which, should I take the act or that amendment?
Oh, the amendment I am saying. What
yes,
changes they are making?
Sir, first changes is they are including the illegal, the immigrants, that is refugees of religious persecuted minorities of three neighboring countries, that is Pakistan, Afghanistan and Bangladesh. There are six religions. They are allowing Hindu, Parsi, Sikh, then Christian, Buddhist and Jaini. The citizenship who are staying here, the deadline is 14 December 31st December 2014. Before that, who are staying here for 1 to 6 years, they will be provided with the citizenship. And there were changes in the year. Earlier it was 11 1 to 6 years. Earlier, all the citizens who were illegal or the people who were illegal immigrants, they have to be deported. But now that six religious persecuted people, refugees, they are included, they are declared as citizenship will be provided to them.
Citizenship will be provided. Tell me, what is your opinion about the verdict given by the Supreme Court in the Ram Janmabhoomi issue? There are some review petitions also. What happened to them? And what is the statement of the, what is the current status of that? What the government has said recently regarding that?
Sir, government recently told that the Ram Mandir, Ram Temple will be constructed within 4 months. And about the issue, there were controversial 2.77 acre land in which the Hindus were claiming that it is the birthplace of Ram Temple, Lord Ram, and there was a temple, and they had given archaeological evidence in form of it. And after that, it was destructed by Muslim invaders, and Babri Masjid was constructed. So some Hindu rightist party people, they destructed that Babri Masjid, and from since 1992 this issue is going on, that is whether to construct a mosque or Ram Mandir there. So the case, the other part, that is the Muslim Waqf Board was there. So it was decided by the Supreme Court that government will provide 5 acre land in that area for the construction of a mosque to the Muslim Waqf Board.
Then what happened? Both the parties agreed with the decision.
Sir, yeah, initially both the party agreed, but later some Muslim people, that is Muslim organizations, they have given petitions against it.
Petitions against it. What happened to those petitions?
All were denied.
All were dismissed by the Supreme Court.
Yes, sir.
So what is the current status now?
So current status, that Ram Mandir will be constructed there.
Government has given some deadline within this month, with this time.
Sir, within 4 months.
Within 4 months.
Yes, sir.
Who said?
Sir, I had gone through newspaper.
Yes, that is true. But who said that? Prime Minister said.
Sir, no minister. That is Sri Amit Shah.
He said.
Yes, sir.
They are saying that they are making a grand temple. We can't make a one-storied house or two-storied house in 4 months. They will make a grand temple in 4 months. Is that possible?
Sir, if more labors will be there, then it is possible.
Has some part been already made and kept, or they will start from beginning? Are you aware?
Sir, some parts was under the ground, that is from archaeological survey.
That is the existing part. No, the new temple that we will do, they will do it of stone or something that they have already prepared, or they will do it now?
Sorry, sir.
Entire structure is ready. It's like building blocks, like khonja ho. That is why they are saying that in 4 months you will finish. Okay, but anyway, that is a separate issue. But you know, you said that Supreme Court granted the other parties 5 acres of land. It was a title suit actually. Title suit, you know what is title suit? You are in the government, you must be knowing. Title suit? Malikana, se jagar malikana ka ghar. Okay, whether this land belongs to A party or B party. That they have decided, okay, it belongs to A. Finished. Why they have given some land to party B? What is the reason? That land which was in question has been decided, the title of this land. Why compensation, some kind of compensation has been given to the other party? Some reason must be there?
Sir, as per my knowledge, there was a masjid also there, like Babri Masjid, for their religious sentiments, they were provided another place to construct a mosque there.
Not a religious sentiment, a wrong had been done there. That was was a criminal act.
Yes, sir.
Right. Which article gives the Supreme Court that power to do so? You are aware?
Sorry, sir.
124? Go and check today. What is 124?
Yes, sir.
Article 124 of the Constitution. What power it gives to the Supreme Court?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, how many Odia people are in eminent positions now, important government positions at the national level? How many do you tell me?
Sir, in
national level, very important positions, okay, in India.
Sir, governor of RBI.
Okay.
That is Srijukta Saktikant Das.
Mm-hmm. Then?
And.
Hello? Already called for children. Can we say, yes, with us, Satpati sir, or Bera sir? How much say about children? Confirm for children. How much is available now? The robot. The robot can be chopped. See, can we see with us on it? How change? What's in there?
Sir, another is Lieutenant Governor of Jammu and Kashmir. Sir, sorry, I cannot remember particular name.
Name that you should know.
Sir.
Okay, that is Girish Chandra Murmu.
Girish Chandra
Murmu. Okay, ex-IS officer of the Gujarat Cut. Shaktikant Das, you said, Mr. Shaktikant Das, he was also IS officer of which cut? Tamil Nadu, just check.
Yes.
You should know that, right now.
Yes.
So before that, he was the, you know, what positions he served.
Yes.
Okay, that you should know.
Yes.
Because he must be having lot of experience in finance.
Yes.
Because he's the finance secretary. Just check.
Yes.
Okay. Because the government just will not give anyone the, you know, governorship of Reserve Bank of India. Right. Two you have said. Okay. Then others. Two other governors are also there. Vishwabhushan Harichandan is there, Andhra Pradesh governor, and Draupadi Murmu is there, Jharkhand governor. That also you should say. Four. Many others are there. Recently, some awards were given by Kendriya Sahitya Academy.
Yes, sir.
And some Odia people have also got awards. Who are there?
Sir, one is Tarun Kanti Mishra. He is the ex chief secretary of Lok Sabha Bhavan. For his writing Bhaswati. And another is Kari Charan Hemra. For Santhali, writing Santhali language, that is for Sisira Jal.
Okay. Which is the last language to be included in the 8th schedule of the constitution? Last language?
Sir, Santhali.
Santhali? Are you sure?
Yes, sir. Boro, Dogri, and Maithili and Santhali.
Sure?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just check again. So, till now, how many constitutional amendments we have had? And which was the last one? Constitutional amendments.
Yes, sir. Abrogation of Article 370, that Constitutional Amendment Bill of CAA was the last amendment.
CAA was Constitutional Amendment Bill? Was it a Constitutional Amendment, CAA?
No, it is the Amendment of an Act.
Huh?
Yes, sir. Constitutional Amendment is last 370, Abrogation of 370 Article.
Sure.
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's check it. So, government has also provided some reservation for economically weaker sections at the central government level, and state governments are free to do so. Which all state governments have done it? Has Odisha done it?
No, sir.
Odisha has not done it. Okay. Which governments have done it? Which state governments have done it?
Sorry, sir, I'm not
done. At least two, three you can say. Many have done it.
Yes, sir.
Two, three you can say.
Sorry, sir, I don't know. Yes.
Okay. So, you studied 10th from Jawaharlal Navodaya Vidyalaya, right?
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me from that respect, what has been the contribution of Rajiv Gandhi to nation building? Jawaharlal Navodaya Vidyalaya is one initiative. Tell me 3 or 4 more.
Another is
he is said to have brought the information technology revolution to India. Are you aware of that?
No, sir.
No. Okay. Have you heard someone's name called Sam Pitroda? Have you heard Sam Pitroda?
Yes, sir.
From which state does he belong to?
Sorry, sir.
The state?
Yes.
Is he from Odisha?
Yes, sir.
So, when you are passing by, have you heard of a hotel aggregator called Oyo Rooms?
Yes, sir.
You heard?
Yes, sir.
Who is the owner of the Oyo Rooms?
Sir, he is from Odisha.
He is from Odisha?
Yes.
Which district?
Sorry, sir, I don't remember, but he is from Odisha.
He is from Odisha?
Yes, sir.
You should know the name and also the district from where he is.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, currently, you know, Odisha has been ranked in something in last 5-6 days, the report has come, which is a very healthy indicator in some aspects related to technology. Odisha is among top 10. What is that? Related to technology. Government is saying digital India, state government is also saying digital. Everything will be done digitally. So in that, from that point of view, Odisha is ranked 8 in something now in India. What is it?
Sorry, sir, I don't know.
That is the Bheem application.
Bheem application.
You know what is Bheem?
Yes, sir.
What?
Sir, it is a platform for the payment.
What is the full form of Bheem?
Sorry, sir.
BH for Bharat.
Bharat. And I for internet.
Interface.
Interface.
For?
Money. Yes.
Okay. The state Indian. Okay. So, Odisha is number 8.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So, you are the secretary to tell me at least 5 programs of digitization, office digitization and other which are being implemented.
Sir, first is OSWAS, that is Odisha Secretariat of Workflow Automation, in which we are going through the files and
which organization has developed that OSWAS?
That is TCS.
TCS is developed.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we have NIC?
Yes, sir.
Do you know what is NIC?
NIC, National Information Center.
Informatics
Center.
Okay. NIC was also there, they could have asked NIC to do it.
Sir, it is a tender process. Organization which bids satisfactory tender, then provided to that organization.
Okay. So TCS has done it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, one is also. Then, second?
Sir, second is our e-Pragati system.
What about that? Is?
Sir, it is related to the all information storing in ICDS project, all over the world, sir, ICDS
project.
Okay, 2, 3. Sir, IFMS.
What is that?
Sir, it is the treasury site in which all the budget sanction activities are going.
What is the full form of IFMS?
Sorry, sir.
Even I don't know, but I will guess like integrated finance management system or something like that. But you have to be sure about it, okay.
Yes,
have you heard of eShishu?
Sir?
eShishu. OPEPA, you have heard? OPEPA?
Yes, sir.
What is OPEPA? Something related to primary education, it deals with primary education, right?
Education.
One of its projects, that is the eShishu project, that got the Prime Minister's award for excellence in public administration.
Yes.
Okay, in India, when you talk about e-governance, in India, which was the first e-governance program, you know, and in which state?
Sorry, sir.
Like we have Bhulek in Odisha. Bhulek is for what?
Sir.
Have you heard Bhulek? The digitization of land records, of the ROAs, etc. Okay, pattas and all, you can see directly, whether it is Nishut or your name or not. That is Odisha, that is Bhool Lake we are calling it, right? Similarly, wherever it started first, digitization of land records, that is the Bhoomi program in Karnataka.
Yes.
Okay. Really, you feel that e-governance and m-governance, this digital platform and all, is actually going to help the poorest of the poor? So let us say I am a person having no knowledge of, you know, I have not studied anything, I am illiterate, I am living in a slum with my family. Okay. How is your this digital, this, that are going to help me or will make a difference in my life?
The first thing is, that e-governance, it leads to transparency. For example,
what will I do with transparency? I am not concerned with all these things. What I need is, if you can provide me some employment, if you can ensure that I get to eat, and if you can ensure that I get a decent place to live, that is all I am interested in. First, if those of my requirements are fulfilled, then I'll think of higher things, right? So how the e-governance, okay, is going to help this poorest of the poor person who has three basic needs, that is food, okay, shelter, and basic amenities like health and education.
Sir, as an ICDA supervisor, I was working. In that case, the e-governance helping whether the person, that beneficiary, is actually getting the things like chatua and egg, which are meant for them or not. Actually, they are getting or not. It complies with the
same. That means it is basically for monitoring purposes and evaluation you can use.
Yes, sir. For monitoring those people who are living in slum and is their basic necessities are getting fulfilled or not, that continuous and constant monitoring can help in transparency. Like when the Anganwadi workers, they are providing the requirement like chakwa and eggs to those poor and poorest, in that position the supervisor is present there, he is clicking the photos and sending it to the higher officer, that is actually it is being provided, and the debtors are maintaining in the register which cannot be edited. If once entered, it cannot be edited in the next month. So there will be maintenance of transparency.
Maintenance of transparency, okay. So suppose you have to make a choice, difficult choice, okay. Two very important situations or important emergencies have come, one on your personal side, one on your professional side. Okay. You have to give your time accordingly. You can't divide your time. You have to take one and you have to leave one.
Yes,
right? What are you going to do?
Sir, I am going to give more importance to my professional side, as I am a government servant and I am under the government duty. So that will be my priority. And in personal side, there are other members of my family who can manage. But in government side, if my duty is very much essential for the government, then I am sure to dedicate that time for the government work.
Okay. So, you have seen all the protests and all violent protests which are going on, if it is talking. Suppose you are in charge of the situation, what are you going to do? Suppose you saw what happened in Gujarat.
Yes.
Okay, a policeman was trying to run away and he fell down and people, you know, almost lynched him. Right? Suppose you are in charge of a group of 20, 30 of your staff. Right? And something of that sort happens. People are coming and, you know, trying to assault your staff and your team. Chronologically, tell me, what are you going to do? First, what you will do, then what you will do, and then what you will do.
Sir, first, when they are violently coming to attack us, then I will sit to a safety location. national song or sowing the flag of our nation, so that the kind of nationalism will grow inside them, and that will lead them to be some kind of peaceful situation will arise. After that, I will try to convince them, and I will speak in a very distinct and pleasing manner that what is the actual situation is, and I will listen their grievances also. I will note down and I will try to convince them.
You think that this will work?
Yes, sir, this will work.
Fine. Okay. You are aware of all the states of India?
Yes, sir.
And all the districts of Odisha?
Yes, sir.
So I'll ask one state and one district. Okay. For the state, you tell me the capital. For the district, you tell me the district headquarters.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Simple. So let us start. What is the capital of Tamil Nadu?
Sir, it is Chennai.
You are? Be confident.
Yes, sir.
Common question. So Tamil Nadu, Chennai.
Chennai.
Subarnapur district. Headquarters?
Sir, Sonpur.
Sonpur.
Sonpur, yes.
Sonpur city.
Yes, sir.
That is the headquarters.
Yes.
Okay, fine. Nagaland?
Nagaland, it is
Kohima.
Kohima, yes.
Sure, Nagaland is Kohima.
Yes, sir.
Okay, and Khorda?
Sir, Khorda Bhubaneswar.
Okay, then Assam?
Assam, Dispur.
Dispur.
Sir, Dispur is their capital, and Guwahati is the main city there.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, Nuwapada?
Sir, Nuwapada. Sorry, sir, I don't know the headquarters.
Okay. Tripura?
Sorry, sir.
Sundargarh?
Rourkela.
Yes,
sir.
Okay. Then Daman and Diu is a union territory. Daman and Diu, capital. Ballangir.
Ballangir, Kantavanchi.
That is the district border.
Yes, sir. That is
sure.
The prominent, yes.
Hmm?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then Uttarakhand?
Sorry, sir.
Okay, fine. So, suppose you are to select a civil servant, right? What are the things that you will see in that particular person? What are the... Suppose government has asked you, you select one civil servant, 10 people are there. You select only one among them.
Yes.
Okay, for a very important post. What are the things? If all are brilliant, all someone is very good in sports, someone is very good in academics, someone is very good in extracurricular, co-curricular activities, okay, someone has foreign experience, lot of diverse profile people are there, 10 people. And you are asked to choose one of them. Okay. What are the things that you will look in that particular person through an interview of 30 minutes? You will be given 30 minutes, take their interview for 30 minutes. What are the things that you will look, and what are the questions accordingly you will ask to get out those things? So for example, you will say that I would like to know the efficiency of that person. So this is the question I will ask for them. Okay. Then, if you want, you can think for 10 seconds and then you can tell me.
Yes, sir. Sir, first I want to know the smartness of that person. That is how she is representing towards me. And second is the communication power in both both in English as well as in Hindi, and also the local languages. questions.
Okay. Fine. That will be the end of that.